Hey everybody, this is Devin with HDPiano.com, and in today's video we're going to check out Wasteland by Woodkid. Pretty cool song, I was definitely surprised when I heard it. It sounds very classical, and it's got this very robotic kind of, you know, super rhythmic piano part that just goes on, and he's got a really cool voice. It's a cool song, I'm stoked. So, let's check out the intro, that's what we're going to do in this video. And as usual, the rest of the videos with the rest of the song can be found at HDPiano.com, home of the hybrid piano lesson. All right, here we go. All right, so that is the intro, but it also works in the moments where the cello plays the melody, so it kind of functions as the interlude as well. And speaking of cello, that's definitely it's probably my favorite string instrument. It just sounds so luscious, especially when you blend it with pop music. You know, it's just a great carrier of melodies. So I'm curious what you guys think. What's your favorite string instrument, particularly in, you know, contemporary music? Let me know in the comments below. All right, so we're in the key of G minor. We've got a very repetitive pattern in our hands, and the good thing about this video is once you kind of get the feel for this basic pattern, you know, the rest of the videos will be a breeze. It'll be just me kind of showing you the different chords, a couple little variations, but more or less we're just doing the same kind of plotting, you know, alternating rhythm of the left hand and the right hand. So we're playing downbeats in the left and upbeats in the right. So I'm just going to show you guys the chords first before we get too fancy with the rhythm. We're starting with G minor, and this whole song is basically in G minor. Alright, so we have G in the left, D, G, and B flat in the right. We've got two beats of this, so one, two. Beats three and four, we go to F, or you could say D minor over F. Because we've got a D minor triad in our right hand, D, F, and A, and an F in the left hand. So that's our first measure. First measure, going between G minor, one, two, three, four. All right, so now we pick up the shape with our right hand and move it up to E flat and play an E flat in the left. So that's E flat in the left, E flat, G, and B flat in the right. And our left hand goes down to a D, and we keep the top note of our right hand, but we take these down to D and F. So those are the first two measures, those are the chords. Let's recap. G minor. All right, we're going to go to D minor over F. Okay, that's followed by E flat. And B flat over D. All right, those are our first two measures. And you'll notice that the bass line is just descending, kind of a quintessential minor descending bass line. Kind of gets that kind of old school jazz vibes or something, but here we are mixing it with a bit of a classical rhythm and kind of a very plodding approach. It's certainly not a swing, not remotely swinging. That's what kind of makes it cool. It's very quirky and stiff, I'd say. So let's introduce that rhythm into those chords that we just learned. So it's just going to be a constant alternation between the left and the right hand. And it looks like this. Okay, and I wouldn't even be very dynamic about it. You want it just to kind of sound, you know, a little bit robotic. It's hard to say whether or not a human is playing that on the record, but whatever they were going for, it's certainly this kind of just stale. Very monotone, just this endless accompaniment pattern beneath the vocal. So one more time, three and four. All right, there's our two first measures, and we've got two more measures to learn, and that will be the intro, which does repeat once for the intro. So it's a four-measure phrase, but it repeats twice, so we have eight measures to form the intro. So next, we're starting off with the same two chords, so that's easy. But then we're going to F sharp diminished here. So we have F sharp in the left hand, F sharp, A, and C in the right. Two beats of that. And then we're back to G minor. And we do G minor. And on the and of four, we hit a D in the left hand. All right, so three, one, and two, and three, and four, and one. And then we loop it again. All right, so one more time, the second two measures, G minor, D minor over F, and here's the new one, F sharp diminished to G minor, where we're gonna add that ominous little bass line. All right, so let me play through the whole intro, or rather one cycle, at a slow tempo. Here we go. One, two, three, and four. All right, notice I'm not doing it staccato per se, but I'm certainly not, you know, using any pedal or holding the notes. It's just kind of like this, filling the length of each beat, but not really going beyond or beneath the exact rhythmic value of just a. Just each hand is trading its place, right? So that helps give it that just methodical, plodding vibe that we're going for. All right, so that's the intro. I'm going to play it one more time, a little more up to tempo. And then I hope to see you guys over at hdpiano.com to catch the rest of the videos for the rest of the song. And it loops. Alright, good work my friends. This is Devin with hdpiano.com, and we'll see you over at the rest of the videos. But in the meantime, give us a like on Facebook, hdpiano, Instagram, at hdpiano, where we're happy to repost your performances. So send us any videos of something you've checked out from our site, and we will gladly share it with our followers. And if you have anything you'd like to request, follow us and tweet at us on Twitter, at hdpiano, using the hashtag hdrequests. And that's how we compile all the various requests that come in every day and, you know, put together a list of what we want to get out there next for you guys. All right, we'll see you at part two. This is Devin, tuning out. Thanks.